So we're ready to play 24, but first, before we start, just because some people might be new to the game, can we get somebody who knows how to play it volunteer to explain all the rules? Eh? Okay, Tiffany.
How to play the game 24 is like they give you four numbers to choose from, and you have to find out the equation to equal 24. You can use multiplication, addition, subtraction, and division.
There you go. As an example, here's one example. Let's see here. 3, 5, 5, and 4. The 24 activity is a set of cards, and they all have four digits. And using addition, subtraction, multiplying, or dividing, you use all four digits to make 24. 21. Is 21 plus 3
20.
Is 24. And 24 is the name of the game. Everything, they're always going to somehow go up to 24. And the students and anyone can just look up and do the mental math in their head or write it down on paper, but they're trying to get 24. And a lot of times, there's more than one way to get 24, which makes it really interesting. Okay.
5 times 3 is 15.
Uh-huh.
Plus 5 is 20, plus 4 is 24.
15 plus 5 is 20 plus 4. Whoa! So there's another way to do it. 5 times 3 is 15 plus 5 plus 4. Cool.
It hits all the basic skills of arithmetic operations, but it does it in a way where you're practicing it without knowing, because you're doing it in a fun way. It just gives them that number sense of the flexibility in math, which I think is a really important context to be learning math in.
So raise your hand when you got it, and I'll try to look for the first person who raises their hand, and I'll try to remember who's second and third, okay? But raise your hand, and then I'll write it down, and we'll see, okay? Here's the first one. Audrey, what is it?
Okay. 4 times 3 is 12. Times 2 is 24. Times 1 is 24.
Ah, times 1 is 24. Good. Oscar has won.
Well, to me, I've never played it before. I really liked it because you use your brain, but like having fun instead of just using it to do things like just sit there and do work. You actually use your brain, but in a fun way.
Oscar has one. Dontrell, you have another one?
3 times 2 is going to be 6. Uh-huh. 6 times 4 is going to be 24. Times 1 equals 24.
Okay. Good, so this, all you did is change the order and you got 24, right? Do you guys think we should count that, those? If you just switch the order?
Yeah.
No, I'm not gonna count those. I'm gonna count it if it's completely different. This is essentially the same thing, right? All you did is move around the order, right? You could also do 1 times 3, right? So this will count as just 1, okay? If you have a different solution, it has to be completely different. Like, use different operations.
24 is good for differentiating between the different levels because the students who are ahead in math, it's basic skills that they're using, but they can think higher level in the sense of they're really looking at for alternative solutions.
Oscar has one. You really have another?
They're also trying to be quick about it, so they're really trying to do it in their head, which is really good practice.
2 plus 1 is 3.
Okay.
Plus 3 is 6.
Plus 3 is 6.
6 times 4 is 24.
Oh, so 6 times 4 is 24. Wow.
I know.
I really didn't know that existed. I thought there was only one way to do this. All right. Let's do another one. 6, 3, 3, and 2.
It's a good after-school activity because you don't have to do much preparation.
3 times 3 is 9. Times 2 is 18.
All you need to do is bring the cards, and they can do it even without paper or pencil because they can do it in their heads.
Oh, Tiffany with 2.
Yeah, that's just fun and engaging, and they're actually doing work.